Greetings, Westmore family, friends, visitors, those watching online this morning. I would like to ask the Lackey family, as many that could, if you could join me across the front of the stage this morning. The Lackey family. I got to spend a few minutes with this beautiful family dedicating their son, Keaton Alexander Lackey, this morning. What a beautiful family. Got a beautiful young man that we're dedicating to the Lord this morning. We're parting the Red Sea for the Lackey family right now. We are witnessing a miracle live on Sunday morning. We talked about the importance of a baby dedication and how the family is acknowledging that their child is a gift from God, a beautiful gift from God, and they want to take a special time to dedicate him back to God this morning. I'd like to give a rose to mom and a Bible for dad this morning. Beautiful family today. Amen. All right, I'm going to ask Pastor if he'd come lead us in a prayer of dedication this morning.
Can we stand together? I think it'd be very appropriate, especially on a day when our children are going to minister to us, to thank God for life. Aren't you thankful for life? Could we give the Lord praise for life? It's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful thing. We have life all around us, and we celebrate a brand new life. Not only a life to the Lackey family, but a life to this church family we call Westmore. Little Keaton Alexander, blessings have been spoken over him. Research has been done on his name, and he's had a wonderful time with the family and Pastor Chris downstairs. And we as a church family want to pray an anointing, a hedge of protection. We want to pray that purpose and destiny will be fulfilled in his life. Could you stretch your hand toward little Keaton, and let's just pray that the Lord will do special things through this life. I'm going to let you hold him. Father, we thank you for life today. There's no life that's chance. We believe that you have a special purpose and destiny for this little life. And as mom stands here and holds him in her arms, I pray that that sweet, precious anointing would rest upon him from this day throughout all of eternity. Let your purpose and destiny be fulfilled in his life. We pray that you would build a hedge of protection around him, Lord, physically and spiritually. And we pray that he would come to know you intimately at an early age. Reveal yourself to him, Lord. And we pray for the parents that you would bring wisdom and understanding as they raise this child, as they steward his life, because ultimately we know that he's yours and he's a gift on loan today. And we pray that he would be managed well by the entire family in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Let's thank the Lord for Keith.
Wow.
He's beautiful. I'm so proud of you. I'm proud of you. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Love you. Bless you. Man,
all the tinsel and
Joy to the world.
Oh, Lord, how long? the Lord. You may be seated.
Amen. Thanks for leading us in those wonderful choruses this morning. I'm excited this morning. The kids have been working very hard on this musical, and it's wonderful to see God use children, communicate stories of godly virtues and his love and the true story and the meaning of Christmas. We've been talking about, with the High Five Kids and Kids Church, about the godly virtue of joy. Now, we're kind of looking at the difference between happiness and joy and how happiness is something that we experience based on how things are going in life, by our status in life, maybe by the stuff we accumulate in life. And the pursuit of happiness ends up being a vain pursuit most of the time. But true joy is something that lasts forever. And we've been simply defining joy in a way kids can understand as finding a way to be happy even when things don't go your way. Memory verse we've been looking at this month is Philippians chapter 4, verse 4. And I love this verse of Scripture. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. And I've been reminding kids that this Scripture verse wasn't written in the middle of a circumstance that was necessarily a happy time. The Apostle Paul wrote it to the people in the city of Philippi while he was locked up in prison. It certainly wasn't a happy occasion. He locked up in prison for preaching the gospel. But Philippians is often referred to as a letter of joy. Pretty awesome when you think about the circumstances in which it was written. It was written to the people of God to encourage them to live a life of joy, serving the Lord, no matter what your present circumstances are. In this production today, you'll find one of the main characters where things didn't always go this character's way in life. So the question is, do they ever find true lasting joy? Without further ado, I want to introduce to you the High Five Kids Ministry, High Praises Choir, production, We Three Spies.
Handled?
Yes, we have no choice now but to activate him.
Activate me? Awesome!
Christmas in Dallas.
Thank you all for arriving promptly at our secret meeting for today's briefing. Obviously, you all view the message hidden in the candy canes you delivered earlier today.
Yep, that's right. Commander, as you can see, we have a little unexpected development.
I think we have all noticed that, Agent E.
Commander, Frankie is a friend of mine from school, and I can assure you he's completely trustworthy.
Agent, this sounds like a conversation that we should have in private, don't you think?
Commander, I just completed a new gadget that will solve that problem. Let's test out my latest creation, the Super Silent Fruit Muffs. Whoever wears them won't be able to hear a thing.
Well, thank you, Agent L. Are those made of fruitcake?
Yes, they are. Here you go. Try these on.
Commander, he followed us here, so I sort of had to tell him we were undercover.
Agent E, you wouldn't want to compromise our whole season, would you? Christmas intelligence kids would not be secret agents if you know they weren't secret.
Excuse me? Just a minute, please. We'll be with you in a moment.
I know, Commander, and I would never do anything to jeopardize the CIK.
Excuse me?
I've done the calculations, and there is a 97% probability that Frankie will make a great addition to the CIK. I had to knock off 3 points for his, well, slight tendency towards clumsiness.
I can still hear you.
Oops! I was so sure they were going to work.
Maybe they need more walnuts. Good news is these things will be good for months.
Agent L, now he knows more than when he got here.
I can fix that. I recently invented a memory erasing machine.
Where is it?
Well, I tested it on myself. So I forgot where I left it. But I'll go look for it.
Agent E, I see you have no choice now but to activate your friend. Your name?
Frankie.
Frankie, this year your code name will be Agent F. Welcome to the CIK.
Sweet! What next? Do I get to go on a spy mission? Take out some bad guys? Can I use karate? Hi-ya!
Whoa! That won't be necessary. Please issue Agent F a hat and a tie. As you all know, each of our agents' hats are equipped with communication devices in case we need to contact you.
Like a cell phone?
Yes, but it's a hat.
May I have an eye hat?
Cute.
I found it. I found the memory eraser.
I just have to adjust the trigger.
Well, don't just stand there, bring it over here.
Bring what there?
Awkward.
Forget her. Let me explain, AJF. We spend our free time every December looking for ways to bring Christmas cheer to people who need it. And this time of year, there are a lot of them out there.
I gathered you all here for a reason. We have a new mission.
Ooh, I love a good mission.
Where's the memory eraser?
Memory eraser? There's no such thing. That's a great idea for an invention. But I do have a new gadget that'll be perfect for a silent night like this.
A silent night?
A silent night.
Kids, why don't you explain it to Agent F?
Blink of an eye, bringing Christmas.
to the needy, do not announce it with trumpets to be uttered by men.
Give to the needy. Do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing. So your giving may be in secret. Matthew 6, 2 through 4.
Now that Agent F has been briefed, I have an urgent mission from my high profile client who has just retained our services. As you all know, we usually like to fly under the radar and seek our own Christmas missions, but this client was particularly convincing on the phone. She insisted on coming in and giving us the mission herself.
Who's in charge here?
I am. You must be Miss King. Agents, I'd like to introduce you to Miss Harriet King.
It parrot rhymes with parrot.
I'm sorry?
It's pronounced Harriet. The I is silent.
You can just sign right here.
Wait, does that say King Harriet?
I said King. She signed King Harriet. Look, King, comma, Harriet.
Well, it looks like.
I know what it looks like,
but... Can we get on with this?
Certainly, Miss King.
Is this a secure location? May I speak freely?
Why, yes. You may speak freely in front of all of my agents.
Agents? Why, these are just children.
Yes, but they are fully trained Christmas intelligence operatives.
They let children into the CIA?
Actually, we're the CIK. Christmas Intelligence Kids.
Oh, well, that's what I get for skimming the contract, I guess.
Now that the team has been assembled, why don't you fill us in on the details of the mission, Miss King?
Absolutely. Lately, I've noticed some unusual activity, one of the many, many properties I own in this town. A local warehouse. It seems that there are shipments arriving every single day. Brown paper packages of all shapes and sizes. Now, naturally, I try to stay out of the affairs of my attendants, but I do need to know if anything illegal is going on. Commander, I could use my new invention, the Jingle Alert, patent pending.
Another invention? Buddy, Agent L, I don't need to remind you about the track record of your other inventions, do I, buddy? The chocolate anti-gravity boots?
The cotton candy umbrella?
Oh no, Commander, not this time. The Jingle Alert has been tested and is field ready. When our CIK team retrieves the information from Miss King, I'll just push this button and alert you here at the base. Then you will know the mission has been accomplished.
It doesn't explode or anything, does it?
Not so far.
All right, Agents E, L, and F, assemble your supplies and meet at 2000 Bethlehem Way at 1700 hours.
Yes, my first mission!
Everyone else, dismiss. You know, we usually like to accept missions that include bringing Christmas cheer to people. After we uncover the information you need, we'd really like to do something special for the people there. That is, if you don't mind.
Oh, well, that's your business, I guess. I just need you to do your spy thing, and I'll take care of the rest.
Understood. Miss King, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas? That's weird. You see, it all started, so many years ago. When I was young, there was a toy store down the street. Can I have a little more of myself on the monitor, please? Filled with fancy toys.
What monitor?
And candy that was sweet.
Did you bring your microphone?
So I wrote a note to Santa, asking him for one thing, a bicycle with training wheels. Waited, but the present never came. That's the day I knew that Christmas and I were through. I don't like tinsel, I don't like eggnog, ornaments or mistletoe, wrapping paper, filling snow, just like elves. They're kind of creepy. and bells of holly, and I'm not too fond of people who are jolly. I mean, really, ho, 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 who's that happy?
I don't like Christmas cards. They annoy me. Just send an email. Reindeer, well, they bore me, and carols make my head ache. So please don't sing them, and don't take this the wrong way. What's all the fuss about? Just one day. There's just no way to get around it. I don't like Christmas. You won't change my mind about it. I don't like Christmas. Everybody, I don't like Christmas.
I expected a bigger response. That's okay, you'll get it next time.
You don't like Christmas? That's just crazy.
Believe it, sweetie.
I don't like candy canes. They give you cavities. And Christmas trees, they aggravate my allergies. Stocking stuffers fall apart, so please don't buy them. And don't take this the wrong way. What's all the fuss about? Just one day. There's just no way to get.
Hidden deep in the fine print. Enclosed states, no celebrating Christmas. Soon I'll have the proof I need, and I can evict them all for good. Wah-ha-ha-ha-ha! I really don't like Christmas!
Can you believe it's nearly time for our nativity play? Thank you all for working so hard to prepare for our community outreach tonight. Before we run the dress rehearsal, are there any questions?
Are we gonna have a snack today?
Can we use real live sheep?
Are you crazy? Who wants a snack on live sheep?
Yes, there will be a snack today, and no, we will not be using live sheep.
Awesome. This isn't a question, but I heard that the Crosby kids had chicken pox.
Yes, I'm aware that our wise men will not be joining us tonight, but God will provide, he always does.
Not yet. We still don't know what's in those boxes.
Wait, we need to be careful not to knock.
Here, let me help. Oops.
Well, who do we have over here? Come on now, don't be shy. Are you here for the rehearsal?
Yes, we are.
Well, it looks as if this will be perfect. Three parts just opened up. Josiah, will you please help our new wives with their costumes? Now let's continue our rehearsal with a song about what was happening before the angels and before the manger. God's people were waiting, longing for a savior.
The people who walked in the darkness have seen a great light. On those living in a land of deep darkness, a light has dawned.
The people that walked in the darkness of night, they so dark, they clouded up the light. In expectation, they waited in faith for hope for the future, a king to save.
God with us.
Before
How are we going to find out what's going on in all these boxes?
I know. We can use my Xmas ray. It can penetrate like most any material and let us see what is inside. Will you go respect Miss Maple and the others?
No problem. Agent F, this is what is called creating a diversion.
Ouch! Oh no, I slipped on a candy cane!
Oh no, are you all right?
Yes, I'm all right. It's a diversion. I'm drawing attention to myself so that Agent L can go figure out what's going on in those packages.
Ah, nice.
Oh, this is terrible. Can you walk?
Are you all right? What happened?
I slipped on a candy cane.
How did a candy cane get on our stage?
I don't know, but I think my ankle
is... Xmas ray worked. Mission accomplished.
Feeling much better, thank you.
Oh, thank goodness. Wazzle, will you please help another boxes that have been arriving all week since the angel shepherds and sheep are already here? Now let's start at the top of the scene with the angels.
And there were shepherds living in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks at night.
Let's stop for a minute. Shepherds, how should you be reacting right now?
Terrified.
I've seen you look terrified, and that's not it.
What about this?
That's not it either. How would you react if your dog ate your iPod? Yes, we're getting closer, but let's keep working on it.
So, what did you find out? Did your Xmas ray work?
Of course it worked! When did my inventions not work?
Oh, I take that back. So what was inside? Was it something dangerous and illegal?
Shoes.
Shoes? We can't activate the jingle alert until we have something more than shoes to report. Let's keep investigating.
Okay, cast, we have our shepherds and angels. Now let's think about the message that the angels brought to those ordinary shepherds long ago. They had been waiting as long as they could remember, and the Messiah was finally to be born. It was the best news that they could have hoped for.
In history, don't be afraid. Though it seems a mystery,
find the little child lying in a manger. This will be a sign. Finally, a savior in a baby.
An update from your team. I'm very anxious to continue my Christmas celebrations.
Don't worry, Miss King. I'm sure the transmissions will be here any minute now.
Excellent. Now, I'll schedule a quick meet here in the lounge while we wait.
Wait. Lounge? What lounge?
that tiny space around the corner?
My closet?
Oh, sure, sweetie.
Precious thing.
Miss King, why are we Commander, why are we helping her?
What do you mean, ain't it, Tiny? She's our client. Of course we want to help her.
She doesn't like Christmas.
Why would you say something like that?
I heard her say it with my own ears.
I heard her say if they did anything with Christmas, she would evict them.
I don't know what that means, but it doesn't sound nice.
It means kick them out.
Don't panic, everyone. We'll simply call the emergency channel in their hats, telling them not to activate the jingle alert.
Attention, I have an update.
We are very excited to tell you that we have surpassed our goal, and our tracking package is coming in by the truckload. At this rate, we'll be able to bless hundreds of families in our community.
I am proud of each one of you. Many of you have even sacrificed buying gifts for your own families to support this community project.
Bingo! I think we got what we need. The packages are Christmas gifts for the community.
Okay, let's activate the jingle alert.
Mission accomplished.
Okay, let's set for the major scene. Narrator.
When they were there, the time came for the baby to be born.
Does anyone hear that? Where is that voice coming from?
My hat. Oh, sorry. I must have left my cell phone on.
Weird ringtone, dude.
I know, right?
Please, everyone, keep your cell phones off until our dress rehearsal is finished. Continue.
She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in the manger because there is no room for them in the inn.
Everybody that is celebrating Christmas.
Trying to evite?
I think you mean evict.
That's what I said. She's trying to kick them out.
No.
We need to warn these people. If Miss King gets here, the whole Christmas event will be ruined.
All right, everyone, take your places for the scene with the wise men.
Miss Maple, we have an urgent matter to discuss.
Can it wait until after this final rehearsal? People are beginning to arrive outside, so we just need a few more.
I hate to interrupt this little celebration.
Ma'am, the doors actually won't be opening for another 10 minutes, but if you...
I've been watching you for a few weeks with all these packages coming in and out. But I need more. I need real proof.
I'm afraid I don't understand.
Of course you don't. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Miss Harriet King, and this is my building. What you seem to have overlooked is that on page 147, section 2, paragraph 3 of the rental agreement, it states no celebrating Christmas on the premises.
Why no? I was not aware of that.
Always read the fine print, dear. I can fix this right here. I'll use my mem eraser on her and she'll forget all about not liking Christmas. How cute, it's a flashlight. Did you forget this? You left it in the lounge. Now, where were we? Oh yes, we were in the violation of the contract to be evicted effective immediately.
What?
Not fair. But what about the gifts?
But what about the nativity?
What about the snacks?
Surely you understand, Miss King, that we have a huge event planned for the community tonight. Perhaps you could...
Make an exception? Because it's Christmas? Not a chance. You have 10 minutes to leave the property, or I'll call the authorities.
What?
Oh. Listen, we don't need a building to show God's love. Our community has been selflessly giving of their time and treasure all month, and I know that God will honor these efforts.
But how do you know?
The Bible says that we can trust God with all our hearts. He's in control.
Mary and Joseph trusted God when they heard that King Herod was searching for the baby Jesus. Mary believed he would continue to take care of them.
Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted among the earth.
There are days you wake up and nothing's going your way. It's not always easy to simply trust and obey.
Outside, and the manger scene will go right in front of the building.
Sure.
No Did problem. I forget to mention that on page 147, section 2, paragraph 4, it states that if the contract is broken, everything in the building belongs to me.
What?
Oh, no.
We'll just start again. It's just stuff. True treasure isn't anything you can hold or touch.
That's right, Josiah. It looks like people have begun arriving. Now let's all go outside and leave. these gifts with Miss King, our celebration of the birth of Christ will go on as scheduled, without the props, the set, and even the gifts.
Well, good. You're all taking this much better than I expected.
I still don't understand. You've been collecting these boxes for months. Now you won't be able to help the community like you planned.
God's timing is perfect, and we don't want to do anything that He is not directing. When it's time to give gifts, He will provide and make a way. Until then, we just need to be faithful and give ourselves to Him as a gift. Are we ready? Places, everyone!
Merry Christmas, everyone, and thank you all for coming. We have encountered a few obstacles today, but we are thrilled to be able to remember with you. The greatest Christmas gift ever!
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in a land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For us a son is born, for us a child is given. The government will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. So Joseph also went to the town of Nazareth, to the town of Bethlehem, to the town of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to marry him and was expecting a child. When they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in the manger because there was no room for them in the inn. After Jesus was born, Magi from the east came and said, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? I saw the star from the east and I come to worship him." When they saw the star, they were overjoyed on coming to the house of the Lord. They saw the child with his mother and bowed to worship him.
Miss King, I bought you something.
What do you mean?
My sister was saving it until I was older, but I want you to have it.
It's a bicycle with training wheels.
You said you wanted one.
But after I tried to stop the Christmas celebration, why would you be so kind to me?
God gave us the greatest gift at Christmas.
And that gift lives inside of us.
Giving our lives back to Him is our gift.
Oh, tissue! I need a tissue! Thank you, darling. And a lot of all your edit extra hot and 12 pumps of vanilla.
Well, I have never experienced this. I'm at a loss, I'd say. A loss. No one has ever shown me such kindness when I have been so, such a teensy, really, teensy little bit left imperfect. Is there a tiny chance I may have overreacted just a little bit?
But when we give to others, we are imitating the actions of the greatest giver who gave the ultimate gift to us 2,000 years ago.
God coming down to earth to save his people. Well, that's just amazing. Well, don't just stand there. We need to give all
all these packages to the people in the community who need them.
Miss King, do you want to help me pass out the gifts?
Well, I could ride a bicycle.
Do you know how to ride a bicycle?
No, but how hard can it be?
Oh, boy.
But first, I feel a storm coming on. Can I have a spotlight follow me over here, please?
Oh, well.
We're on it.
Thank you. That's better.
I like this garden. I like this wreath. And those jolly little elves.
Well, I guess they're kind of sweet. I like those carols. So keep on singing.
I just want to stand and say, let's all celebrate Christmas Day. There's just no way to get around it. I love Christmas. You won't change my mind about it. I love Christmas. I love Christmas. Everybody, there's just no way to get around it. We love Christmas. You won't change our mind about it. We love Christmas. We love
Christmas.
Wow, great job. High five, kids. Great job. Praise the Lord. What a message. What a message this morning about the Christmas season. A wonderful time to be grateful and to celebrate the unconditional love of our Savior Jesus Christ and then go spread that love unconditionally to others around us in our lives. Awesome job, guys. What a wonderful job of acting and dancing and singing. And we know this doesn't just happen overnight. It's a team effort. A lot of hard work goes into putting on a production like this. There's a few ladies that I'd like to spend a moment honoring this morning. Miss Carissa Baker, you come out here. Miss Shannon Carter, Michelle Wetherill, and Miss Jennifer Browning, and Miss Fabby Baker, if you could come up here and join me on the stage this morning. Give these ladies a hand. There you go. These ladies have worked so hard for several weeks, all the way back in September, they begin an audition process with the kids and assign the kids the right parts and the solo parts and all the acting, the blocking, the choreography, the work on set design and getting all that stuff together and directing. They do a wonderful job. Just give these ladies a hand again. They do such an amazing job. And the kids, you guys were awesome. Let's give the kids a hand again this morning. Awesome job. Awesome job this morning. We Three Spies, Christmas Intelligent Kids. I'm glad these kids are intelligent about Christmas. They know the true meaning of Christmas, and that's something to celebrate this holiday season. I'd like to ask Pastor if he would come forward. Ladies, thank you very much.
Wonderful, wonderful job. Amen. Some 2,000 years ago, wrapped in swaddling clothes and laid in a manger, was a Christ child we call Jesus. And our peace, our hope, and joy was laying there in a manger. As we celebrate on this third Sunday of Advent, we celebrate joy. Laying there in the manger was joy. Woven throughout the Christmas season, historically, joy is a theme of Scripture. And this week, I want to encourage you to remember to joy. Seize joy. The question is, how do we do that? I think Pastor Chris, opening our service today, mentioned Philippians 4:4. He says, rejoice in the Lord. Sometimes, always. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men, for the Lord is at hand. So how do we seize joy? Well, we rejoice. We repeat joy. We exercise joy, and we do it, according to the Apostle Paul, by standing on his promises and by understanding the Lord is at hand. We're told in Scripture that laying in a manger was our Savior, our King, our Lord, our everything, our healer, our provider. We need to seize those promises and just be thankful and joy in the Lord. If you have a need in your life, this week would be a great time to joy in the Lord. And if you need the healer, joy in his promises. If you need the provider, joy in his promises. Rejoice, repeat joy, and do it always. Let's joy in the Lord. Amen? This was wonderful. You did a great job, and we're so proud of you and the great job you did. We love you. Wow, you're all smart. You know that? You knew that, didn't you? You knew that, didn't you? You're all smart. Yeah. Let's give him one more hand. Let him know. Wow. Yes. Amen. Let's stand together. Father, thank you for your gifts. We're reminded during this holiday season of how many gifts we have. And right here in this room, gifts are all around us. We thank you for your gifts. And we pray, Lord, that we would exercise joy today and throughout this week as we joy in the Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great day.